Hello, everybody. We're back after a quick little mid-season break for Fight Rundown episode 209.
Actually, it's 210, I've just realised.
210.
We always do this, but we're going to do the episode UFC 210. Preview.
Yes, yeah, episode 210. Obviously, me and Jeeva here, but we're joined by a very special guest today, Mr. Bailey Legg. How are we?
I'm good, thank you. Yourself, boys?
All good. Yeah, it's a nice Sunday morning / afternoon, almost.
Back to the usual, isn't it?
Yeah.
Always on the Sunday mornings.
100%. And like we said, we're joined by Mr. Bailey Legg. How are we doing?
I'm good. A bit of controversy coming today, boys, isn't there? Let's be honest.
Yeah, we've got a misfit in the room, as they call it. You know what I mean?
Lot to talk about. We'll get into it. We'll go from there.
Right, this guy's running the episode here. Yeah. I mean, a lot to talk about. Oh, you tell me what we're talking about, eh?
There you go.
No, I'm jokes. But yeah, obviously, Leggy, you do influencer boxing, you see now. You know what I mean? Obviously, you've been training, working hard, and now you're stepping into the influencer scene. Obviously, we've spoke a lot about this. You know what I mean? We're not selling out. The boys stay the same. Me and Bowles still going to give our same opinions on it.
Of course.
Well, actually, opinions might have changed, but we're still going to keep it real. But yeah, just intro it, Leggy. You've got a fight coming up. Tell us about it.
So, got a fight, 28th of September. First fight. Am I nervous? No. Never am nervous. Never will be nervous. Everyone says it. End of the day, I know what I'm going to do. And I'm going to win. And it's that simple.
Hey, this guy.
I like that.
On it. He's on it.
Confidence.
So how long have you been boxing?
So I think my first session was like a year and a half ago now. And then obviously we had that appendix injury back in November last year. I was out for 4 months. So a long time, but now I feel I'm ready. Do you know what I mean? It's ready to get my first fight underway type of thing. Whatever you want to say. Not good with words. but yeah, first fight coming. And to be fair, win, lose, or whatever happens on the night, I definitely want to get a couple more fights in before the end of the year.
Ooh. When you first started boxing, was that always the plan to get a couple fights under your belt and actually compete?
As soon as from the start, I've said, like, this time frame, I want to have my first fight. And the actual date was like May this year. So obviously we're a bit behind, but obviously I had that injury. So it put a big delay on them. As always, you don't want to rush something when you're not ready for it in a combat sport. You know what I mean?
Is my mind working? There we go. Do you feel like you're ready now? You know what I mean? Is there any, you have no doubt in your mind? Hello? Hello? That's never happened. That's a nightmare. That's really
wound
me up.
Yeah.
There's like no doubt in your head. You feel like you've done everything now. You're ready to go.
I think, obviously, I've still got a lot to learn. There's a long way to go in the boxing scene. Obviously, you look at the amateurs already. There's a different level. You could put me in the ring with any amateur. Realistically, they're going to probably spark me out. Let's be honest. But on the influencer scene, it's a different style. You're bringing in a bit of the boxing audience, but you're also bringing out like a different audience over. So I think that's why I like it, and it's sort of my vibe. So, yeah.
I've got to ask the question, why not the amateur boxing? You know what I mean? I know, like, a lot of our audience is kind of the traditional boxing. I prefer the traditional boxing. You know, I don't think I'll ever pick the influencer scene over, like, you know what I mean, pro boxing. And when you got into it, did you not think, like, right, if I'm going to work this hard, why don't I do it properly? Which I do think is properly, you know what I mean? I'm not trying to disrespect your... or what you're doing, but it is proper, isn't it? Bowles, I don't know about you. Do you see it the same? Like, you're putting all that work in. Would you not want to think, right, if I keep grinding, let me try and win the amateur, like, go maybe get a couple fights in the amateurs and get that, or even do that before going into influencer boxing?
But then also, I do agree with that 100%, but then let's get it right as well. Like, it doesn't mean that you're just now an influencer boxer. You could do what you like after that. As well, you can go back, you can jump back into the amateur scene if you wanted to. Or if you wanted to stay in the influence scene, it's completely up to whoever's boxing.
I think for me, it's like, obviously, built up a following for a long time now, and whatnot's gone on over the years. And I just think that for me to go into the amateurs, what do you get out of the amateurs? Most people I don't really know what they get. Yeah, you box to a high level, but then what's next? You go pro. And for me starting now, am I anywhere near a pro level? Will I be near a pro level in a couple of years or years? No. Do you get where I'm coming from? So
yeah.
For me to go on the influencer scene where I could get to a top level on that scene and it'll be a lot of audience, which then obviously will work with my following and bring a lot more people in. And it's sort of like a job. It is a job for me. So
yeah, of course, the influencer scene is bringing money in, isn't it, compared to the amateurs?
Exactly that. It's more like the viewage as well.
True.
Do you know what I mean? Yeah. You're going to have more eyes on you. If I'm going to be in the amateur scene, it's... You don't get many people there.
Yeah, he's right. With the amateur scene, you really do have to be the best in the country for anyone to know you, really.
Yeah.
And that is true.
It's true, yeah. Unless you're a diehard amateur fan.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Or
yeah.
You got a coach, or obviously Tommy. Every fighter. I can't believe this. It's really wound me up. The worst part is I'm going to spend 20 quid on a new wire right here. You know what I mean? So we'd have a budget for that. But like Tommy knows every fighter. He knows every amateur.
Yes.
So does Joe. A lot of the kind of box, if you're really good in that scene, you kind of know everyone, don't you?
Yeah.
But as for like you said, the influencer scene, you're getting a bigger name earlier. And also it can translate into other things, can't it? And more opportunities. So yeah, tell us about your fight then. Who are you fighting? What's the date and where is it at?
So it's 28th September in Bradford, and I'm fighting a kid called Matthew Rose.
Has he had many fights?
Yeah, do you know anything about Matthew Rose?
I don't know this guy, to be honest.
It's a bit of a bold one to take. I've seen, obviously, him fight, and I thought, you know what, I probably get the win over this lad. It's not going to be easy by any means. Little did I know, after watching that and accepting the fight, he's had 24 fights. 23 fights, sorry. 9 wins, 10 losses, and 4 draws.
Jesus.
4 draws.
Yeah.
Suspect scoring.
Yeah, very. So he's clearly active. Whether or not he's putting in the training, I doubt it. To me, he just looks like he just wants a bit of a scrap.
Yeah.
And he's one of them. And I think that's what a lot of the influence scene is. Some of them work hard. Like, you see the top level with some of the best coaches in the world. And then you go down to small level and like, well, I just want to scrap and get my name out there. Obviously, I've been training. I'm ready. It's one of them. I can't see myself losing. You can never say never. We all know that. It only takes one shot. But definitely preparing for the fight, and I will perform, put on a show.
I like that. And like you said, a lot of these guys are looking just for scraps and stuff. So what is the goal? Are you looking to go maybe 3-4-0? Wait for it. Is Misfits the end goal? You know what I mean, at the moment, it's the only one people care about. You know what I mean? The only reason why anyone would care about Speedstar, for example, for me as a casual and don't know the scene, is because my friend's fighting on it. You know what I mean?
Like, are you looking to build up a Speedstar sort of resume going on, beat everyone, then move up? Or are you looking to, like, what is the plan for you?
I think at the moment, the plan is just to get this first fight out of the way. Obviously, I would say, I want to fight again, probably twice, maybe 3 times before the end of the year. Get the record up. That's if it goes up. Obviously, as you say, never say never. And from there, I think obviously the end goal for anybody stepping in this scene is Misfits. And I think if I get a good record on the go, the following will go up. Calling a few clowns out. There is some in mind, and we will probably get on to them later.
Jesus.
I'm excited for that.
And then take over the Misfit scene.
So let's kind of transition away from the boxing. You've built a big following up, you know. Is it 30K you got on TikTok? Insta?
Yeah, just under 30K on Insta. I've had a couple of TikTok accounts, but been banned 3 times for being a pain, doing stupid prank videos, whatnot.
So as like, obviously we're working hard on the following and stuff. What's your kind of method into kind of getting big? Was it accidental? Was it natural? Like, oh, this one's banged. Like, what was your kind of algorithm? Because, I mean, Bowles has hit some big numbers on TikTok, and it's kind of more interesting, like, a strategical aspect.
Yeah.
That most people go on, how many views are there on TikTok, and how many people are banging views? You know what I mean? How many people are getting big followers on Instagram? You know what I mean? So what was your method, and when did it all start? So just transition away from boxing.
For me, it started in lockdown. I was making videos about literally pranking teachers. Remember when we was all in, well, you boys probably won't be in school, but I was in my last year of school and everything was on Zoom calls.
We was in our last year of college, so.
Yeah.
So I was in.
On Zoom calls. So I'd joined somebody random Zoom call and I'd just start rinsing the teacher, rinsing the kids. And obviously the kids had started like getting clever and that, so the views just went flying. And then I think I got a lot of reports and whatnot, so that account got took down. Obviously still had the footage, so I put it on another channel. Got to about 250k in about 4 weeks on that account.
Jesus.
I was flying. I thought, here we go, yeah. Then that account got took out.
And
it was a real kick in the teeth. And I think that's where I then, like a year and a half after I was reevaluating, is this for me? Do I want to do it? Because you can go so far. You can go so far.
This is 2021. Yeah. You was reevaluating like halfway through. So
yeah,
kind of as the world started opening back up.
Yeah, exactly. And I was thinking, is this for me? Because you could go so far and then all of a sudden, bang, your account's gone. You're back to square one again. And as I say, I've done that 5 times now, so it is a pain. But I think I've got that core audience now. So it will get there.
When it comes to building up an audience on TikTok and whatnot, what advice would you give to people who are looking to start up their own thing and do their own thing on TikTok?
I think a lot of people get like nervous about what people are going to say. Obviously, when I first started, I got so much hate, like from people around here. People wanted to fill me in. To be fair, I even got like some random kid must have put. We know his name now. No name's mentioned, but was putting death threats through my door.
What?
Oh, death threats?
I didn't know
door.
This.
Yeah. So a lot went on and. There was a lot of reevaluation, but it's not going to be like that for everyone. As I say, it only takes one video.
So you were 17, 18, right, living with your mum or dad.
Yeah.
What did they say, knowing, like, you was getting death threats? Was they telling you to pack it in? Like, did you think, oh, this is just stupid, like, it's affecting our lives?
Yeah.
And how did that make you feel, knowing, right, I'm doing well here? Obviously, you could get 1,000 nice comments, laughing faces, but them two horrible comments, and then the death threat. Did you already always know, like, these guys must be jealous, you know what I mean? Or did you think, right, it's not worth it, it's affecting my mum, it's affecting my dad?
To be fair, it really didn't affect me, it didn't really affect the family. We all just sort of laughed and joked about it, and I think that's the sort of family we are, and we just get on with it. What will be, will be, and obviously we know the lad that did it, and let's be honest, he's a bum.
I don't know who this is, but
sounds like a bum.
That's what they say, though, isn't it? If anyone who's hating on you isn't do better than you, I kind of like
exactly.
Saying,
yeah.
You know what I mean, me and Bowles got it. You know what I mean, it wasn't so much to our face, but the amount of people that was like, you heard. You know what I mean? Or,
yeah,
these lot doing it for what? 7 people, or they're just all like idiots. And then the same people are the ones who like you see out and like, oh, you're smashing it. You know what I mean? It's like,
exactly.
It's the same thing. And we're nowhere near as big as your social platform by any means, but. I mean, we can get it to an extent.
Takes time, boys.
Yeah, 100%. 100%.
And it only takes one minute video. And this could be the video.
I hope so.
Show your support.
So, yeah, so you always knew. So, did you have a formula? Was it like, right, the Zoom things are banging? And then did they ever start falling off? And then you had to reevaluate, like, what's funny? What can I do that's hilarious?
So,
or what bangs? Did you have like did you have a thing in your head like, right, I'll do this, milk it. When the views started dropping off, move on. You know what I mean? And just keep reinventing.
I think obviously once I got them bans and that, I thought, I've got to stop that now. So I've got to look at other things. So then obviously that's when I went to Magaluf in the summer. And I went up and down the strip asking just drunk people, stupid questions. And that's what then sort of started to get views.
Yeah, 100%. And, I mean, Paul, do you ever think that, I know, like, you produce so much content, do you find something that works and, like, you stick to it, or...?
I feel like with the stuff that Bailey does, you know, you got the relatable content and you've got you're going out to different countries and making that. I feel like that will always do well because there's such a wide range of people who can relate to it or enjoy it. I think with us it's a little bit different when it's such a niche... You know,
market,
combat sports is so niche. It's going to be difficult, a lot more difficult for us to blow. You know what I mean?
But, facts. Yeah, that's so true.
But yeah, it's one of those. You know, you just got to keep pumping that content out.
Exactly. That. As I've said multiple times, it's that one video thing,
and that's it. You just got to think about like it could be the next video, and then you just got to keep thinking it could be the next one. It could be the next.
So
one.
True. There's one video I do want to talk about yours. You know what I mean?
Here we go.
It was actually a live You ate three ghost chili peppers.
Oh, it was actually four.
It was four.
Four ghost chili peppers.
And obviously, you was covered in snot. He was covered. What was the damage like? Why'd you do that? You know what I mean? Well, did you? Because I can't lie, the views were banging. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, you was absolutely smashing it. So, was every time the view went up, you're like, right, I've got to do another one and keep the audience. They've got to see it.
It was sat there with like over 1,000 people on the live at one point, and I'm thinking, the comments are going, eat another one. And I've had two at this point, and I'm thinking, right, I've settled down a bit now. Let's just have another one. So, I had another one. I've done it loads before, but I've never done it like more than two. Two is like my limit, and I think. So I've done it again. But the worst part about it is because obviously I've the powder gets all on your fingers. You can't see it or anything. You wash your hands, it doesn't really come off. And I've like rubbed my eye, and that's when it
rookie mistake.
Yeah, exactly. So my eyes was going, my nose was going. I just remember, honestly, I literally thought that was my life done.
When you're having like four of those, does it get any easier, or is it just every single one just as shit as the last one? Like,
I think you go from it hits its max level, and then you drop down to about 50%, and then you're adding another one on top of that. So the fourth one is
Jesus. Yeah. That was such a funny video.
I remember putting my hands in the ice cream and just like trying to force it down my throat.
Yeah, that was too funny. And then what else I got to ask? You're an influencer, right? So what is a day in the life? Because 85% of the world, you know what I mean, or at least most people our age are working 8 till 5, 7 till 3, somewhat hours like that. What is your day? You know what I mean? Do you plan out content? Are you obviously training much more now? Like what do you kind of do in the day?
If we go off like
go from the morning. What time do you wake up?
Say we go from like tomorrow morning, I'll probably what time will I wake up? Probably wake up about 7, between 7 and 9, because a few things like doing my phone, getting into a bit of trading and a bit of gold investment and stuff. Trying to invest my money wisely, do you know what I mean? So I get up early and then I'll probably do like some light exercise, get me breakfast in me, and then from there...
What's your breakfast?
Depends. My breakfast is...
Don't have to act all good on the pod. No, you know what I mean? I want this honest.
The boys stay the same.
Yeah, well, no. Don't start chatting like this sourdough and avocado bread. Yeah.
No, so...
Great combo.
I've never had avocado. It just freaks me out. Looking at it. Okay. So I can't bring myself to try it. Maybe one day.
You can have four ghost chili peppers, but not an avocado.
Yeah, I don't know.
Right, so go on then. So what's breakfast?
Right, so it's either. I've got three options.
Right, okay.
So.
By the way, you look like the type of guy who eats like the same thing every morning.
Yes.
You
know what I mean? Yeah.
Like, exactly. And it's pretty boring. Like, you just look like that. So,
porridge.
Yeah.
Basic. Yep. Or Crave, one of the most elite.
Crave, red or purple?
I like the purple.
Red.
I'm red.
Red.
I've never had the red.
Red's hazelnut.
Chocolate hazelnut.
Nah. I thought red's milk.
Oh, is it?
I think the cheap Tesco one though, so it might be different from actual Crave.
Oh, Choco Pillows.
Yeah.
Choco Pillows.
Okay, right. So porridge, Crave, or...
Or the go-to, and you... I don't know if you like this, boys, but... Three waffles, potato waffles.
Okay.
Four eggs, fried eggs.
Right.
Beans.
I love beans.
HP brown sauce.
I like beans. Should have just have a full English, you know. You're halfway there. You've put the effort in.
We've established I'm not a bean guy. I'm like,
That's true.
In the past. I do not rate it. Full stop.
Yeah, that's your bold statement.
I like the Crave. Crave's good, porridge is good, but that third one...
What, you're picking balls out of them three? I think I'm taking the porridge.
I got a porridge, yeah.
Yeah. Any toppings on that?
My issue is I put a bit of sugar on. Maybe a bit
I don't mind a bit of sugar. There's a bit,
and then there's like...
How many tablespoons are you talking about? Teaspoons?
I don't think tablespoons is an option here. Like, you know, your actual spoon that you eat the porridge with, like... Fucking boof. Like the top layer is literally...
I can't lie, if I have porridge, I want to load it up. You know what I mean? Yeah. I put like a bit of granola in to get the crunch.
You need to get a bit of syrup in there or something.
Yeah. Honey. Syrup. Honey's made. Honey. A bit of cinnamon. Yeah. Fruit. Yeah. Dark chocolate. That's the one right there. All right then, cool. So, sorry, what's after that? So, I've just done breakfast and moved on.
Yeah.
Obviously, in the morning, I'll sit there at night, anyway, on my phone, on TikTok, looking at video or ideas. Or I might see a video and I think... I could do that, but I could do that better. So it's a bit like copying, really. And then there might be other videos where I could do that, but I could add this to it or change this to it. So I'll sort of spend the day either planning, doing the videos, but sometimes what I like to do, I'll have a couple of days each week where I'll go, right, this is content day, and I'll smash out, we're talking like 20 vids.
Okay.
In one day, and then for the rest of the week, I'll just not do a video and just post it at times, so it's just a chillax life.
I like that. I like the honesty, you know. Yeah. Like, you got a good life. And you said, like I said, you got to invest your money. I mean, the influencer game's not forever. Or it potentially is. I mean, I look at the side men.
Do you know what? I think it is. It is forever, but are you going to be 45 doing it?
True, yeah.
Yeah.
But you, like, but point I'm making is...
get your kids involved.
Facts, family channel.
Family channel, you know what I mean?
Point I'm making is, like, you're using it wisely, you know what I mean? Like, obviously, you're making money from it. Sounds like you said you're investing. I'm guessing that takes a lot of time up, day trading in gold.
Yeah, it does take a lot of time. But don't mind it.
Right, so we're going to move on back to the boxing, back to the influencers. I'm going to throw a name out, right?
Yeah.
And you've got to say smash or pass. But not the pause, you know what I mean?
Smash or pass?
Yeah.
Are we talking like in a...
Not in a sexual way.
You mean like you'll bang him out or you'll duck him?
Yeah, not suck the dick, you know what I mean? Yeah, not suck the dick, yeah.
No slops.
Right, starting off.
So this is me right now, yeah?
Clipping that. Right, yeah, this is you, so Neon.
Oh, smash.
It's got to be.
Yeah. Smash.
Jack Doherty.
Oh, 100%, I would smash. That is one guy that I think the world hates. Yeah,
no Diddy. Oscar Willis.
I don't even know who that is.
Legend. The Mac Life. It's the Mac Life interviewer.
Oh, is it? Yeah, he's pretty good.
He's had one.
Smash, though.
Okay. Would I take him? Well, I think I might take Oscar at the moment. He's had an MMA fight. It's good. Trains McGregor's gym. Jay Hon Ingram. Don't know him.
Smash.
Don't know.
Dave Fogarty. Just lost to that.
You know what?
He lost to Dean the Great.
Dean the Great. To be fair, he outboxed Dean the Great, I thought, at times.
Okay.
But it was clear to see that he couldn't take a punch, so I'd say smash.
Ace Musa.
Ooh, he is very, very sharp. But, that's such a close one, you know. But it's
probably, is that a fight you want?
It's something we could look at.
That's a Misfits fight right there. That's Misfits caliber.
Misfits card, yeah.
Argentinian King.
Oh, 100% smash. Smash, 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 smash.
You calling him out?
One guy, one.
Wow. You calling him out, right? Argentina.
Argentina King. I even pre'd his DMs, to be fair, and said that I'd smash his head all over.
Oh, wow. What did he say?
Didn't reply.
You're not that clouted, mate.
not that clouted.
Speed.
So. I show speed.
Ooh, I think that's an easy...
Pass that.
I don't think he's that good, man.
He hit harder than Chama.
No, you'd smash him, but you wouldn't want to do that. Speed, man.
Do you reckon you'd smash speed?
100% you'd smash.
Bold statement. That guy's just nuts. It's like he's one of them people, just you natural
miss
everything.
Miss one guy. One guy that 100% is a smash.
Him.
Most wanted. I'm coming for this guy, no matter where. No
coming matter for where. You.
Okay.
Straight up.
Wow.
Like, this is like...
Most wanted.
Yeah, like, this is seriously, it's not even on
Need
the...
Need for Speed, most wanted.
He is your most wanted. Literally.
It's not even like on the influence scene, like, we're talking, if I go to this event and see him, he's getting straight up nutted.
Really? What's this about? What's the backstory between them?
Just stick it on him.
Why?
Just stick it on him.
What's he done wrong?
What's happened here?
He's just... He just talks. And he ain't come direct at me or anything like that. He probably don't even know who I am. Well, he does know who I am, actually, because he's viewed my profile a couple of times, like, seeing the stories and that. But he don't say a lot to me, but behind the scenes and stuff, you hear a lot of talk by him, and I was thinking, yeah, he needs another slap.
Someone who puts a sour taste in your mouth. Just grind your gears.
You listen to him, you think, oh, mate, you're boring me now.
Yeah.
So you want him?
Yeah, definitely. I'd 100% look at that as probably one of my first fights. Honestly.
Is that his actual trim?
I think that's a hat, chief.
Okay. Fox the G.
Right now, I'd probably pass that, you know.
Okay.
But he's another one. He did a lot of amateur bouts.
We'll do a few more. Luke Bennett.
Oh yeah, it's gonna be a smash. You know what I mean?
I think Jag, your little brother, sorry, takes Luke Bennett.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah, but in MMA, yeah.
Yeah.
Actually, in anything. Yeah. I think most people. I think your little brother would as well, Luggy.
Probably.
I think Steve also.
Yeah, I think he would, yeah.
Small Spartan J, someone in your weight class now?
Yes. Do you know what? I'd probably smash. I'd smash.
Okay. Bowles, anyone on this list you would, you know?
I'm going top level. Top of the bar.
Evil Hero. What a weird name.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, smash. To be fair, Bowles, it looks a bit like you.
Let's go to the heavyweight division for Bowles. And Jeeve. Bowles versus Haseem Rahman.
So
that'd be a good fight. Bowles versus Haseem Rahman.
I'd beat Haseem Rahman Jr.
What's Greg Hardy?
Come on, man. That's the easiest
fight.
That'd be
a good fight, though. That'd be a good fight.
He punches
UFC
hard.
UFC fighter.
Yeah, he punches hard. Yeah, but he is a wash, didn't he?
Yeah. Yeah. HS TikTok versus Bowles. Taking Bowles.
I think I've got enough there. I think
either Tempo Arts? Champion?
You'd beat him, Bowles.
Oh, he's a fatty, isn't he? No, you know what? He's undefeated, isn't he? What is it like? Oh, no.
I'd beat Tempo Arts.
You think we both beat Tempo
Arts? I'd beat Tempo Arts, yeah. And I know the leggy thinks Tempo Arts would win. I can tell by their reaction. I'm not even lying, I'd beat him.
Okay.
But I will no longer be a heavyweight.
I don't really know
next
him.
Time I fight, so.
Don't really know him, to be fair.
Yeah, that's all the YouTube stuff.
Tyson Fury on there.
Yeah, I know. I've just checked his record. He's 1-0, apparently.
Really fight?
I'm guessing this is the Ngannou fight, yeah.
That's sick.
It says bout pro, but he won. Was it for the titles? No.
Yeah, this website's washed.
Yeah, I know. Any place you do want to fight, and if you... I'll ask you two questions here. Any place you want to fight, and if you were to fight on a Misfits card, who would you want to main event? Or who would you want to share the card with?
So, if I could fight anywhere. I'm not going to go out the park. If I was to go big time, like we're talking Villa Park, big Villa fan.
I knew you was going to say that, yeah.
But if you wanted to go smaller, is it like, the NEC in Birmingham?
Yeah, Resorts World now, I think.
Yeah, it's a lot smaller. But the thing with that is I know most of my mates and all that from around this area where I live would come across today, so that's fine. But in Birmingham, I know that I'd have all Villa support there. I know a lot of Villa fans obviously go to all the games.
Yeah.
So definitely somewhere in Birmingham.
And who would you like to share the card with? Don't say KSI. You know what I mean? Like a realistic possible main event for your first fight.
Realistic main event. Not had a fight yet. However, I have seen, I think I mentioned it to you the other day, Jeep, Ashley Banjo from Diversity.
He's boxing?
He is meant to be fighting him versus HS Tiki Toki.
He's a legend, Ashley Banjo, you know.
Would be a fight and a half because they're both huge.
I didn't know he boxed, but
yeah,
he was a coolest guy.
Training at Anthony Hatch.
Well, he's definitely not winning then, is he?
Yeah, that Tunde is crap, isn't he?
I like Tunde. It's just an absolute party over there, isn't it?
Yeah.
He will be doing more dancing than boxing, so that suits Ashley Banjo.
Yeah.
Love Yard. You know, in Yard.
But, so probably be you rooting for Ashley Banjo in that?
Yeah. I like HS TikTok. I watch all his videos. As you know, I'm rooting HS. I want HS. Yeah. Anything else, Bowles?
No, not really, to be fair. Just make sure you tune in to watch Bailey fight. I mean, at the end of the day, you know, the fight run down, boys stay the same. The influencer scene isn't our thing, but you know what? As long as Bailey's fighting in it, it'll always be our thing.
Yeah, 100%. We're not on that too much, but I try and keep in loop. I've been enjoying some of them. I watch quite a few of the cards.
Some of them can be all right, though.
Yeah, you can sometimes, but then sometimes it's terrible.
You've got a favourite fight that you've watched?
Oh, that's a good one.
Favourite fight? I think it's got to be Dean the Great versus Wooly Chucks was probably one of the best fights that I have watched on there.
And you watch a bit of UFC as well?
As always.
Yeah, you're a big UFC guy? You always ride with the fight rundown picks?
I always ride with the fight rundown picks.
Gotta ride.
I'm trusting the boys, whether or not it comes off all the time. You know, won't talk about that too much. But I do enjoy my UFC. Solely for the reason of previously this boxing card, you get like the main event, maybe the co-main, and the rest of the card's like you have to sleep.
Yeah, it's dog wank. Right.
The UFC card is always good. I don't think I've known a UFC card to be like crap.
Yeah, like the whole thing's enjoyable to watch.
Yeah, yeah.
I think that's about everything, to be fair.
Yeah.
Not too much to say. Again, like we said, Leggy fighting September 28th, live in Bradford. Speedstar Boxing. I think the link's in your description or something.
Link's in my bio.
What's your Insta?
Bailey Legg. So there will be a, hopefully, got a pay-per-view for it. It will be streamed on the Insta. All the build-up. Make sure you watch it.
100%. Like we said, follow us on TikTok and Instagram at The Fight Rundown. TikTok, literally the latest news. All the latest news is there. Loads of interactive stuff. Bowls grinds it out. Instagram is more where you see all the updates of the pod, what's happening with it.
And Facebook.
Oh,
as well.
Of course, yeah.
Follow us on Facebook as well. Get that audience popping on there.
100%. And your mum and dad. Yeah, we know the older graphics.
Well, this is what it's for, yeah.
So, thank you for joining us. We will see you soon.